everyone. Sat Sri Akal, Namaste, Salam. This is Dr. Biba Singh, and I'm back on my TV show, Rhythm of Healing, with a very special guest today. Jo mere aaj de guest ne, he is a young man who is a true inspiration. He has a journey that is motivating to me and many others. He started out in one career and switched gears, which he is going to tell us about. He is a positive energy and light to all he is around. He is a great husband, brother, uncle, son, and person. Let us welcome Harveer Singh.
Welcome, hey, Sat Sri Akal, everyone. How's it going?
Harveer, welcome to our show. Thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
So, Harveer, sare viewers nu dasso, tusi ki karde ho?
Well, so I'm a realtor right now, and I've been doing this for a few years, but I originally started off my career as a CPA. I'm still a CPA, but now I've switched gears into the real estate world. And so, you know, this year has been really crazy in general. With COVID, obviously, has ruined everyone's fun. No fun at all. And so, basically, just wanted to talk to you about real estate and just my career.
So, tusi bolya ki tusi pehla CPA si.
Hanji.
So, ek CPA, tusi sare apne CPA de exams bhi clear kitte, and you've like full-fledged CPA. And I know you were also working for one of the big
Big four accounting firms,
Ernst & Young, right?
Yeah.
So, tusi CPA to real estate to kisna?
I know. It's very funny. People find it to be the most ridiculous thing ever. Mm-hmm. But for me, it was my only human interaction was me yelling at my computer screen when I was working at Ernst & Young. So for me, I'm a very social person. And throughout my whole career, right from the beginning, my family does real estate as well, and my father is a doctor. So throughout my career, I've been helping manage with these properties. I was learning along the way with my father, and it just happened that we made a business decision that I would get my real estate license, and from there, we would save some money, and you know, it was a business decision. But then, slowly, as time went on, you know, people would come and say, hey, you're in real estate, can you help us? And it turned out to be something that I absolutely loved, because you end up working with people, you're speaking with people, and you're helping them with their biggest assets. Most times, when you're buying a house, it's hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Yeah.
So it would just turn into something that I absolutely loved.
So basically, tusi ek chota shonk to shuru karke, tusi ek career banaya de vich.
Hanji.
So which is really cool, yep. Which is very nice.
Thanks.
Tusi recently you also won tusi number 5 realtor in all of Jersey on social media te aaye.
Yeah.
So you won an award, which is quite an accomplishment. Congratulations.
Thank you. So.
And tell our viewers about this award.
So yeah, it was a kind of a surprise for me. You know, I've started in real estate a few years ago, but marketing is extremely important in any business. So I wanted to do something different. When I came in, I thought, what can I do that is going to make me stand out? Mm-hmm. And that's what marketing is all about, and branding. So I did very many different strategies. So one of which was creating a sticker with my face on it. I don't know what, but it's a sticker with my face on it. I have a nice, like, you know, inspirational quote. It says, "We will thrive again." So I'm posting this everywhere. And so social media is one thing where you could actually show your personality, and people can look at your Instagram, your Facebook, and kind of get to know you in that way. And so I focus a lot on the content that I created, which was funny things that also gave an educational value. And I made so many friends during this quarantine that happened. Nobody was going out, so everyone was online. So for me, I took this as an advantage. And I really focus a lot of energy on getting to know people in my community.
That is really, really cool. Main tera Instagram dekhdi ha. You are very funny. Real Estate Singh.
Yes.
So,
find me.
You're not just a realtor, but you're also a comedian.
Yeah, right.
So, you know, you have a lot of funny stuff on there. So, all our viewers watching today, you know, Real Estate Singh. Harveer, you know, you're doing real estate, you're helping people, but you're also, tusi aaj sade show te aaye ho, Just Punjabi. Tusi sadi community vich ek sardar hoke, ek young motivational like person ho ke jo you've been raised and born here and you know jadon koi realtor vaste dekhta hai apna car lena chahta hai you know like I think it helps to be able to relate ke agar koi meri culture nu ya mere background nu ya meri like thought nu samjhega then that person might be able to help me better so like you know how do you think that being you know a Punjabi man you can help our community with this because like you know I know for example desi community which I soche ke car asi lena hai jithe school sab to acha hoye ya you know log acche hon ya I mean and for our Punjabi people watching today can you you know speak a few yes. words of Punjabi for us too
okay of course so basically it's you know my identity right being a Sardar has helped me in many ways, right? Growing up, my father and mother worked so hard, and I saw that. You know, seeing their struggles and them succeeding has taught me that I could do the same thing. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of one thing where I could relate to other Sardars and everything, where and Punjabi people and Hindu people and Muslim people and everyone, because they feel comfortable with me. And I think that's normal, right? You know, it's somebody who grew up in a similar culture as yours has helped. So it's something that I think is an amazing thing. And me wearing pug and having a beard and just doing my Instagram and showing my culture while I'm also educating people, it's extremely important because it identifies me as a different person. Mm-hmm. And when somebody walks on the street, you may not recognize them. But then when you see a Sardar or me walking on the street, it just my face looks so different. And so
log tanu pehchan
yeah.
like people can
yeah
tanu pehchan sakte
haan ji yeah
yeah and you know I know that you speak Punjabi and you understand Punjabi
yeah
and I know it's with a little accent so
yeah.
But it's good that you do you know sade aajkal youth vich bahut bacche ne jo nahi bol sakte ya nahi samajh bhi nahi sakte so I think that you know that's really good ke tusi apni culture nu alive rakh rahe ho
yeah
How has real estate changed after coronavirus we're in COVID-19 real estate which the log kar agar dekhan jana chahnde ne viewings I mean like how has this industry changed
so everything changed. So once March hit, and you know the market crashed, and everyone was in quarantine, the whole real estate market screeched to a complete halt. And so, basically, what happened was that everything became virtual. You know, online and you know social media. So. Now, what they're doing is that we've created videos for all of our listings. So you do video walkthroughs. So before you go into the house and put yourself or anybody at risk, you look at the video and see if it's something that you like. And if you like the property, then you move forward. You know, you have to wear masks, you have to wear your gloves, and everyone's taking extra precautions going forward. Like you need a pre-qualification letter, which is basically the bank tells you, you know, if you could qualify for a property, they'll say, okay, you know, let us see your income, your
expenses. So you're
expenses.
Like serious.
Yes,
not
yes.
Going ke card dekhna hai to chalo waise hi chalo. Like you have to actually.
Yeah, you have to show that you're actually willing and ready and capable of purchasing a house. And this kind of weeds out a lot of people who are just doing it casually. And so basically makes the sellers feel comfortable that, you know, we're, you know, making less people come in to the house. And buyers also know that they're going to be taken seriously.
Right, right. And what about like with coronavirus, like how I know that interest rates bahut acche like ho gaye ne, it's low ho gaye ne. I think there are lots of foreclosures, you know, and it also commercial real estate.
So
I know there's different
yes, different that. Aspects. So actually foreclosures have not gotten very crazy yet because the government is backing businesses and people and allowing them to move it down a little bit. So when coronavirus hit, everyone ran from Manhattan, everyone ran from these bigger cities and they're all running to the suburbs. So now the suburban and the rural area prices have actually gone up.
Oh.
Yes, so it's those areas in the suburbs that are actually getting the biggest, strongest seller's market that they've had in many years.
Wow.
And it is unfortunately, any commercial properties have taken a huge hit. So Manhattan, for example, you know, we're right outside of Manhattan right now, they're probably going to be, you know, having a lot of issues because they are primarily commercial properties, you know, offices, and now, you know, people are not going back to work anymore. So,
ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ Zoom ਤੇ ਜਾਂ video ਤੇ ਕੰਮ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ. So, do you think ਕਿ coronavirus ਜਦੋਂ ਖਤਮ ਹੋਣ ਤੇ ਆਏਗਾ, like vaccine will come, all this stuff, do you think people will start going back into offices, or you think people will still work from home?
You know, it started now. So now everyone wants to sit at home in their pajamas and work from home, right? So you're not going to be able to, you know, I think that some people will go back and some people are going to stay at home. If you don't need to go to work, they might allow you to stay at home. So that's why I think that it's still going to be a struggle in cities, major cities, because of this.
Right. And Manhattan, I mean, do you think that we'll recover?
We will recover. We will recover. So don't worry about that. We will thrive again. But basically, it's going to be a slow progression. I think once the vaccines start coming out and people start taking the vaccines, then you're going to slowly see the Broadway shows coming back. Movie theaters are going to come back. Then all the performing arts, restaurants will start opening up again. And then the scene will come back again.
Right.
But it's going to take some time. I think once, you know, the vaccines come out, then slowly people will start getting back to normal. The old normal.
Right. Because we're living in a new normal right now,
yes.
Which is strange. Let's talk about entrepreneurship. What advice do you have for our youth out there, you know, who are living in this world? You know, what would you tell some of our youth?
Yes, so I think that what's happened is that people end up pigeonholing themselves in industries that they don't enjoy. So for me, I did accounting, and I thought it was great. I loved it. But for some people, they love it. But for me, it was something that I didn't have a passion for. I think that you need to do something that you have a passion for, because when you have passion and you really enjoy what you're doing, you love it, then going the extra mile is not going to be something that is very difficult to do. And you're going to happily do it. And people see that. People see you're happy and you're cushy and everything like that in the, you know, the work that you do.
Yeah. I have so much more to ask you about your positive attitude. We're going to be right back after a break. Thank you.
All right, thanks.
Welcome back to Rhythm of Healing. We are here with Harveer Singh, Real Estate Singh. And asi gal kar rahe si, Harveer, to see advice de rahe si youth vaste. About, and also, like, you know, what I love about your Instagram when I watch is, like, your positive energy and attitude. You know, how do you... Tell us about that. How important is it to
Yes.
have?
So I think for anyone who's doing any business, there's two things that are going to make you successful. I think one is a positive attitude, and one is persistence. And both of those things are extremely important.
So mehnat.
Huh. Yeah, a lot of work. And don't let your failures stop you, right? Steve Jobs, you know, J.K. Rowling, all these famous people, Bill Gates, do you think that they just were successful from the first step to the last step? You think every single time they just never failed? You know, all of these people have failed hundreds of thousands of times, but the difference was that they were persistent and they kept moving forward. And that's the important part, is that you can't let the small things stop you, or you can't let the big things stop you either. And now what's gonna help you get back up is your positive attitude. So if you're happy and you believe in yourself and you believe in the people around you and you see life in a happier way, then picking yourself up when you fall down is not gonna be as difficult to do. And I think that's extremely important to success in any industry. What do you think? You're the psychiatrist.
100%. 100%. ਤੁਸੀਂ ਅਗਰ ਅੱਛੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕਰੋਗੇ, ਅੱਛੇ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਮਿਲੋਗੇ, ਆਪਣੀ ਸੋਚ ਨੂੰ ਪੋਜ਼ਿਟਿਵ ਰੱਖੋਗੇ, and it really, really helps, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
and motivates you.
Yeah, and you have to feed your mind positivity. A lot of us just naturally have a negative mindset. You know, sometimes it's like, oh, I'm looking fat today, or oh, you know, I you know, I'm feeling bad, or the weather is bad outside. But you need to start training yourself to think in a more positive way about life. You know, we're here for how many years? 80, 90, 100 years maximum, right? So you have this much time on this earth. You need to do something about it. Be happy about it. And, you know, when it comes to business, you know, make yourself different. Take the risks. What's the harm in taking a risk? What's the worst that's going to happen?
Right.
Somebody's going to say no, right? But what's really important is that you take these risks. And that's why for me, my social media, no other realtor does what I'm doing right now. They don't put their faces on their Instagram. They just put photos of their listings, photos of their properties, inspirational quotes. But in reality, there's no interaction there. There's no relation to that type of
right.
post.
Right.
So that's why I put my face out there. I educate people. I make jokes. So if you want to see them, make sure you come find them on my Instagram, and we'll be friends. I'd love to connect with you guys.
So another question. I know in New York or New Jersey, agar koi property lab rahe, real estate, koi bechna chanda hai kar ya lena chanda hai. New York and New Jersey you cover.
Yeah.
But what about the rest of the country?
Okay.
And the world.
All right. Well, all right. So now we have a large network of realtors and they're all vetted. They have criminal background checks. They're required to have done a certain number of transactions in the past. So they're professional full-time agents. So if let's just say you are in Pennsylvania, if you're California, if you're Texas, you're Ohio, you could still reach out to me and I'll still be able to help you find an agent in your area that's actually qualified. It's very hard sometimes to find agents that are professional.
So you can connect, because your network is not good, so you can tell that this agent is good or not, or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
Which is really good.
It's important.
So that's good. And what about in the other parts of the world?
All right. So unfortunately, if you want to work with me, you're going to have to come to New York or New Jersey and come to America. You know, apna kar samajh lo, aajo, come on. You know, things are getting a little normal here in America. So just come on back and, you know, we'll get things going over here.
Yeah, so it is possible. Agar koi dusri country ch rehnda aur itthe property khareedna chahnda hai, ho sakta hai. I mean,
yes.
There's a way.
There's always a way. You know, so if you, that was something that you were looking to do, you know, feel free to reach out.
Yes.
I'm happy to help.
And I want to ask you, Javier, I know that you always support the youth, and what I know is that you were born and raised here, and yet you're a Sikh boy, Sikh man, I should say, following our traditions, following our roots, and I find that it could be very hard, right? Ek America ch reh ke apne case rakhne aur ek sardar like culture nu apnana. How was it growing up for you? Was it hard, you know? And how did you continue with this?
I think, you know, there are a lot of, you know, Sardar kids, a lot of Desi kids in general. You know, it doesn't have to only be Sardar kids that we do get picked on, you know, growing up. And I think that every difficulty that I have, you know, gone by growing up, you know, I was bullied or I was made fun of or anything. These were things that taught me lessons in my life and they've created who I am today. So if I was bullied one day, you know, I learned something that day, you know, about mm-hmm. how I should react and how I should take life. Mm-hmm. And that's extremely important. So I think, you know, the youth that's out there, if you know, you're bullied or anything like that, mm-hmm. just keep your head up high and realize that you're not like everybody else, right? You're different. Mm-hmm. You know, it's our imperfections and our differences that make us unique. And these are the things that are amazing. So some people might be shy about certain things. You know, me growing up, I had a beard in middle school. So nobody had a beard in middle school. But, you know, it's just funny because these are the things that make you different. And you should really start loving yourself. And the things that make you different make you unique. And that's what people remember you by.
Right.
So start taking your negatives and turn them into positives. And that's extremely important. And obviously, like you said, like my parents, you know, my dad's a doctor. My mom's been so supportive growing up and they've, you know, worked so hard mm-hmm. to get, you know, our family where it is today. And so I learned from that. You know, I'm emulating them. You know, I'm seeing them. My dad and me would go to Burger King when we were children, or when I was a child, and we were years ago, and he would clean up the table. And I was like, Dad, why are you cleaning the table? I mean, there's people here, they'll do it. And he said, no. Like, look, we're Sardar. We're already fighting an uphill battle. So wherever we go, always give a good impression.
Ah.
Always. Show yourself, you know, and do the right thing always. And so it's funny, this tiny, tiny things that, you know, my father and mother would tell me, it's just completely changed my mindset and has helped me be who I am today.
That's really, really amazing.
Yeah.
What and who inspires you? I mean, I think in our lives, there are multiple people, but if you could think of like some people that have really been an inspiration to you in your journey.
I mean, it's you know, yeah, there's so many people. Well, first of all, my wife, she's amazing. She inspires me every day and pushes me to be better. She supports me in all of my endeavors. And sometimes when you're jumping off, jumping out of the corporate world and running and doing your own thing, it's a scary thing to do. And yeah, it's good to have support there.
So they always say behind every successful man is a woman who's behind it.
Well, so, you know what? We're in the future now. So maybe there's a, for every successful man, there's a strong man. For a woman, there's a strong man behind him.
I'm only joking.
I think
what we should say is कोई भी successful person वास्ते एक partner होना और support system होना बहुत जरूरी है.
Yes, and I'll also give my parents credit. I think going from child to growing up, they've made me so strong. They explained how I should handle situations. I saw how they'd done things, how hard my dad and mom worked on making our family what it is, and that's just something that I'm grateful for, and my two sisters as well. Both really hardworking and always been so supportive to me.
Which is awesome. Tell us, Harvir, who are you as a person? I know you like to do a lot of different things. What are some of the things that you enjoy?
Getting to know people. So that is number one, right? I go to restaurants and I meet the owners and the managers and the staff. And everywhere I go, I try to make some sort of connection.
Do you know what in Punjabi, ada matlab ki honda hai?
Ki honda hai?
Punjabi ch kehnde ne bada milapra banda hai.
Milapra.
Like, very social. Like, yes. Bada lokan nal milna bahut pasand karda hai. So I think you must have gotten that from your dad.
Oh, yeah.
Your dad is very social.
My dad is extremely funny.
And your sisters.
Funny. Yes, and my sisters.
So tell us. I'm sorry, I got you off track, but tell us what you like to do. So socializing,
look, man, this COVID has made me a hungry man. So I love to eat. And so that's definitely one of the things that I love doing. I make some food, play some games. But to me, it's about meeting people, getting to know people and getting out there. And, I used to love traveling. I still love traveling, obviously. COVID's kind of stopped that, but meeting different people, meeting different cultures, meeting different mindsets of how people think that came from different backgrounds, it opens your mind. And by doing that, it makes you a better person, I think.
Yeah, I think definitely when you meet people and you get to know like certain things that they do and why they do them,
yeah,
in my field, which we, a doctor, no, we both log milte ne, and both acha lagta hai. Or music, which we. To see, by the way, asi rhythm of healing show te hai gaya.
No.
Or nahi nahi. Ek cheez nahi. Tusi dasi apne baare. Tano music da vi shauk hai gaya. I'm not gonna make you sing.
Okay, good. Thank God.
That you actually play a bit of the guitar and basics, and I know that you sing very well. I know kyunki main tera Instagram pe follow kar diya, and well. You're here.
Maybe in the shower.
But
no, I enjoy it. I think, first of all, our culture is so different, right? I tried to figure out and learn the dhol on my own.
Yes, you play the dhol also.
Yeah.
So can you tell us about that?
It was a passion, right? And to me, I wanted to connect to my culture, being a Punjabi kid growing up in the U.S. And honestly, I had no Punjabi friends. In my area, there was nobody. Right, so I was connecting to the Punjabi culture in whichever way that I could have. Mm-hmm. So I bought a little dhol. I just started figuring it out and learning it on my own. It's just something that I absolutely love to do, and that was that.
So how did you learn to play the dhol?
YouTube, watching other people. What I always say, right? And another thing that's good for the youth is if you're trying to be good at anything, emulate the people who are already good at it. Mirror them and copy them and see how they're doing something successful and then make it your own, right? So for me, I would just go on these videos. I used to love Dhol Foundation growing up, and I would see there was 10 dholis on stage, and it was just so amazing. So
I actually performed at an event where they performed.
Yeah, they're so awesome.
They're amazing. yes. What does the future hold, Harvir? You're such a creative person. Music, real estate, traveling, socializing, entrepreneurship.
No.
What do you see in your future?
The future is vast. I don't know. I'm going to go with the flow. Wherever life takes me, I'll be happy to do that. I'm very interested in politics, so it's something that I plan to look into in my local area.
So we might see Harvir Singh a politician someday.
Maybe. But we'll stick to what I'm good at for now.
So main zarur kehna chahungi. First of all, thank you so much for being on.
Thank you for having me.
And what I want to say is ke assi itthe ek show te aa just Punjabi rhythm of healing de utte aur assi sade desi log jo dekh rahe ne, I love bringing bringing people like Harvir, you know, our youth, our, you know, representatives of today on our show, because I would say to all of you, support them, you know, help them flourish, because this is our own, you know, our own future. And people who are younger than you are going to keep following you as an example. And if we as a community don't support each other, nobody will.
Yes. So the best ways for you to contact me, one was obviously Instagram. But if you don't have Instagram, you could reach out to me on my email. It's harveer.singh@randrealty.com. So that's harveer.singh @randrealty.com. So I'd love to connect with you guys.
And you know, you're a handsome, very handsome Sardar. So I want to make sure audience nu dassan ke ida hunai nava nava vyah hoya is karke koi rishte na laake aana aur you know kudiya.
Oh gosh, no.
Chalo, very nice. Thank you so much, Harveer.
Thank you.
You know, thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me. Sat Sri Akal, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.